vlog time. Vlog time is over. Oh my gosh. I don't know if you heard that, but that farting was just Alaska. And as you can probably tell, I am filming on a cat tree, which is why Misty just like crawled up and oh my gosh, now she is chewing on my camera. Wow. This is a chaotic start to today's vlog. All right, hello. What I'm trying to say is welcome to today's vlog. I think I'm gonna have to move locations because Misty will not stop rubbing her face on my camera. So thank you, Misty. Thank you for that. I guess I am not going to be using that cat tree as a tripod right now because Misty wants to eat my camera. That's about all I have to say. Hello. Where are you? What are you doing? Do you want to say hi? Do you want to come vlog with me, Alaska? Look at the camera. Look over here. Misty is currently looking out the window. She's watching people go by. Misty and Oryx both love to just like perch on this tree here and look out the window. A lot of the times you can see like squirrels and chipmunks and stuff running around, and Alaska's over here burping. You burping dog. Oh, such a pretty cat. You're so pretty. Yes, you're pretty too, Alaska. You're very, very pretty as well. Okay, so this is kind of a funny thing that I want to talk about. You may have heard me earlier talking about Alaska farting. You know, when I first started filming this, she ran right up to me and just farted. Alaska has some of the funniest dog farts I have like ever heard in my life. And the reason why they are so funny is just because you hear them every single time. You know, I feel like most dogs when they fart, they don't really make much noise, but a lot of the times they smell. Alaska is the complete opposite. I have literally just never smelled a fart from Alaska in my life. However, I hear them every single time. Multiple times a day, she just like audibly farts and I think it's hilarious. Anyways, I think that is enough discussion about dog farts for now. So why don't we head down to the basement? I have some things going on down there. So almost every single light that I have in my pet room here is on a timer. So normally when I come down for the first time during the day, all of my lights are already on. However, I do have a few that aren't on timers, so we're gonna go ahead and turn those couple on, and then I'm gonna show you guys what is going on down here. So this one here is one of my few lights that isn't on. Now there's no animals in this enclosure. It is basically just all of my plants, and by all of them, I don't even mean all of them because I have a lot that aren't in here. So right now I have a few plants in here, but I am going to be changing this up soon. Right next to this like plant enclosure is my cat gecko enclosure, and I think I'm gonna turn this one into another cat gecko enclosure since I do have some more cat geckos now. So plants probably won't be in here a whole lot longer, and then we'll have some more cat geckos here. But while we are looking at some plants, I figured that I'd give you guys a quick look at my monstera here because, oh, I am so happy about it. It's doing so well. So I bought this monstera last summer. So like I've had it for coming up on a year almost, and it is just growing really well. These are like one of my favorite plants. I think they're super cool looking. So it's really exciting to me how tall this plant is getting. I mean, this like exoterra here is 2 feet tall. And as you can see, the leaves are almost touching the back. We have a new little sprout right there that's probably gonna like reach the top. And this one right here is another one of my favorite plants, this little peperomia here. And then we also have a spider plant here. This one here isn't one of my like personal plants. I think I'm going to use these in some enclosures. We have an aloe and like my fishbone cactus, which I really like. This is another enclosure plant. And then we just have a few more plants that are just kind of lying around right now because I'm trying to figure out what to do with them and where to put them. I don't really know. So they're all just scattered around right now. Okay, so now what is going on in my animal room? What are these updates that I talked about? Well, I have some really exciting ones, and they have to do with
eggs. So take a look at this. We have two beautiful gecko eggs here. So these eggs are actually from Avery, my Chihuahua gecko. If you're familiar with Avery, you might know that when he was younger, I believed he was a male, but turns out that Avery is actually a female and has laid some eggs for me. So these eggs here aren't fertile at all. You know, I have never bred Chihuahua geckos. Avery has never been with a male. These are just infertile eggs, but they were really cool to find regardless, and like, I don't know, they're pretty good looking eggs, so like, I thought that it would be cool to show them to you guys. So here's some Chihuahua gecko eggs. However, those are definitely not the only eggs I have to update you guys on. As many of you probably know, I did have 4 cat gecko eggs incubating, so we're gonna go do an update on those, as well as even more eggs. So not only are we checking on cat gecko eggs, but we have another species of egg to check on. Do eggs have species? I don't know, that sounds weird. The species of egg. Alright, so what is going on with the cat gecko eggs? So as you can tell just by, you know, looking in this container, I do only have 3 eggs in here now instead of 4. So I did start out with 4 eggs, but one of them unfortunately did seem to go bad. Now, I'm still not confident about that, so I actually just took the egg out and placed it in a different container. It is still possible that it could hatch, but you know, I don't want to risk it being a bad egg and then potentially causing issues for the other good eggs here, so I did remove it. However, I do still have it incubating and we will see if it hatches or not. So bad egg aside, let's talk about these 3 remaining good eggs. So these eggs have grown so much since I got them. I'll like insert a picture here of their size comparison, but like you can really tell that these eggs have gotten a lot bigger than when I first got them, which is really exciting. These 2 eggs right here are like huge. I feel like they should just be hatching like any day now, but I've been feeling that way for a few weeks, so hopefully they hatch soon. Like, they are really, really big, and hopefully this one continues to do well and get bigger. So yeah, there's a little update on the eggs. So far, these 3 are doing well, continuing to grow. So we do have 1 that isn't doing too great, but so far the other 3 are still doing awesome. So hopefully there will be some baby cat geckos crawling out of these eggs soon. I keep getting sidetracked by plants, but here's another one of my plants that I really like. I wanted to show it to you guys because this plant makes me very, very, very happy. So this is my Alocasia poly, and I'm just really happy with it. This is my first Alocasia I ever got. I've heard that Alocasias are pretty, you know, they can be pretty finicky, but I've had this guy for like a year now and he keeps just like putting out new leaves. I mean, like, there's only a couple leaves right now. He did go through a little bit of a rough patch where he was losing quite a bit of his leaves, but I was able to, you know, kind of bring him back from that. And now this leaf right here just like uncurled like 2 weeks ago, and now you can see that there's another one right here that is about to uncurl. So yeah, and this plant has gotten so much taller since I first got it. It's like 2 feet tall now, and when I first got it, it was like as tall as this one leaf right here. I honestly feel like this might be like one of the old original leaves because it is way down on the like stem here. You can see that it is a very, very old leaf. So yeah, I don't really know how many of you care about my plants, but this plant in particular makes me very happy, so I wanted to show it to you guys. So let's get back to talking about eggs, because like I said, the cat gecko eggs aren't the only ones I want to update you guys on. So take a look right here, guys. I have 2 new eggs to show you, and I'm so excited to talk about these. So these 2 little eggs right here are quite a bit different looking than the other ones. These ones are basically perfect circles, and they're also hard-shelled, not soft-shelled. So these 2 eggs right here came from my Thacodactylus oscrobopornorum. I am probably saying that completely wrong, but I honestly, I don't know how you say that. That's the best that I can do. I believe the common name for that species is St. Martin's turnip tail gecko or something like that, but I don't know, it's something like that. But regardless on how you pronounce the name, I have some eggs right here. So let's talk about why this is both very exciting but also a little bit sad. So I'm sure you guys can tell why it's exciting. I got fertile eggs, which is like exciting on its own,
but there is a story to go with it. So I have had my pair of Thacodactylus for almost 2 years now. I got them in June of 2019, so yeah, like just about 2 years. For the first while, I didn't have any success breeding them. I wasn't getting any eggs or anything, and I'd gotten to the point where I had almost just given up and assumed that at least right now, I am not going to be able to breed them. So after that, I kind of just like stopped bothering checking for eggs and stuff, and yeah, I didn't find anything for quite a while. So now the unfortunate side of this story has to do with Turnip, who was my male of the pair. So my pair was named Turnip and Bean. Bean is the female, Turnip is the male. So let's talk about what happened with Turnip. So a few weeks ago, I came down into my animal room and I noticed that Turnip was acting kind of weird. These geckos are kind of similar to day geckos in the sense that they're very fast, they're very flighty, and not very easy to handle, you know? They're much more like day geckos than they are crested geckos when it comes to their movement. And I noticed that Turnip was just chilling on the bottom of the enclosure, not moving, not really reacting to me being there, which was a bit strange. However, I didn't think a whole lot of it immediately because sometimes geckos just want to be on the ground, you know? He wasn't doing anything else strange. He wasn't like looking weird or anything. So I didn't really think anything of it at the time. And then I, you know, just went on with my animal care and did all my stuff. And I went back upstairs. Then when I came back downstairs, I noticed that he was in the exact same position that I saw him in the previous night. But this time he looked like he had kind of fought, like he was like tilted weirdly and just looked very uncomfortable. So at this point I went to remove him from the enclosure, and when I removed him I was super shocked because he barely reacted to me at all. Again, like I said, these geckos are normally like day geckos, so the fact that he was just like letting me pick him up and handle him was very, very weird. So at this point I decided to take him to the vet, so I called my vet and I made an appointment. Now I had to wait a few days, and during these few days that I was waiting, Turnip still continued to just barely move. He was acting just like barely alert. He seemed just not there. It was really strange and it was really sad, and I was worried and scared. And yeah, I was worried that, you know, he wouldn't even make it to his vet appointment, but thankfully he did. So I was able to bring him to the vet, and the vet checked him out, and we unfortunately found that there was a very large mass in his abdomen. It was a tumor, and it was basically inoperable. And the vet suspected that since he had one tumor so large there, that there was likely a lot of other smaller tumors that weren't immediately being picked up on the test. So overall, things just were not looking good for him at all, and I ended up making the decision to have him humanely euthanized, which was really sad. I was really upset about it because everything happened so suddenly, you know? He was perfectly fine until he wasn't, and a lot of the times that's the unfortunate truth with reptiles, is a lot of the times if they're sick with something, they hide it very, very, very well until they just can't anymore. So, you know, there was never any point before this that he presented any signs of having a tumor or anything. So it was just really shocking to find that out, and also find out that, you know, it had progressed so far without any previous symptoms. So unfortunately, I did have to say goodbye to Turnip a couple weeks ago. So at that point, you know, I assumed that I, you know, wasn't gonna breed them. You know, they hadn't bred at that point, and now obviously I only have a female, so decided that this species is just, you know, not a species that I guess I will ever have success with breeding. Until just recently, when, you know, things kind of changed. So I noticed my female getting quite large in the abdomen. You know, she was looking like she was really, really, really eating good. And I was kind of surprised by this, you know? I was like, is she just overweight? Do I need to put her on a diet, or is there something else going on? And then the other day when I was doing some enclosure cleanings, I found an egg and I took that egg out. Right away, I assumed that it was just an infertile egg, but I took it and I shone a light through it and it was red. It didn't glow yellow, it was red, and that means that it's a fertile egg. And so after I found that one egg, I was like, oh my god, like I should probably do a really deep clean in here, and I did, and I found a second egg. So to find those eggs, especially after, you know, the sadness of losing one of my geckos, was just so, so incredibly exciting to me, and it's just like very special, you know? It seems just like very, very special to have found two fertile eggs just only like 2 weeks after I had to say goodbye to my male. So, you know, that was kind of like a, almost like a happy ending to an unfortunate story. So I ended up talking about eggs way longer than I planned, so I think a lot of the other updates and stuff that I wanted to give you I'm going to do in next week's vlog, but I thought that I would give you a sneak peek at some stuff because I have some really exciting things going on, such as these giant enclosures right here, which I have not shown on YouTube at all. I have some brand new giant chameleon enclosures behind me. But my chameleons are not the only animals who got some new enclosures recently. We have a new chubby frog enclosure. We have a new salamander enclosure. We also have a new crusty enclosure for Mr. Oliver right here. And quite a few others, such as a new tree frog enclosure, a new legless lizard enclosure. So, yeah, lots of new eggs and also lots of new enclosures. So in my vlog next week, I'm going to give you guys a closer look at all of these new enclosures that I just was talking about. So if you want to see those enclosures, make sure you stick around for next Monday's vlog, and I will be showing them all then. So with all of that done, you know, now that we have talked about eggs for a very long time and just some other various things, I'm going to go ahead and end this vlog here. This was my first weekly vlog that I have, you know, ever done. This is the start of weekly vlogs, so please let me know what you think of it. You know, if you enjoyed this vlog, just like any comments and suggestions on more things you want to see. I don't know. Like I said, I'm new to this whole just like weekly vlogging thing, so let me know what I can do to make them better and more enjoyable, but with that said, I do hope that you enjoyed this one today. So like I said, I am posting a vlog every Monday, and then I'm also posting a non-vlog type video every Thursday. So if you want to see those, make sure you are subscribed to my channel if you aren't already, and also hit the notification bell so that you never miss an upload. If you did enjoy this vlog, I would appreciate it a ton if you gave it a big thumbs up. It really helps me out, and it makes me really happy. Also, be sure to check out all of my social medias. They will all just be down in the description below, but I would love to have you guys over there, so make sure you do that. And now that all of this is said and done, I'm going to end the vlog here. Once again, thank you all for watching, and I will see you all on Thursday.